Hi and welcome to the Cult TV Sofa. This is a reaction video for the 8th and final episode of the only season of Manimal. You can now watch the full reaction to this episode on my Patreon channel. The link is in the description below. Last time we saw a Chinese gangster who called himself the Dragon threatening locals in Chinatown for money. One of JC's friends was threatened and JC stepped in to help, of course. JC and Ty visited the gangster's casino and had to fight off a group of his men, but JC changed into a bull and got them free. After brushing up on his martial arts by watching animals move, he had a final fight with the gangster and won, giving the local businessman the confidence to stand up and give evidence against him. So let's see what happens in this final episode. I'm going to put any relevant trivia that I find over here, and at the end of the reaction I'll be discussing what happened and my thoughts about it. And I'm going to start it in 3, 2, 1.
A man with the brightest of futures, a man with the darkest of pasts.
Why the darkest of pasts? What did he do that was dark? We're not aware of anything. Just the fact that he learned how to change into animals. It's not like he was a bad guy in the past. Night of the Beast. It's obviously my life story.
Door's open. Hello. It's him. He's got the briefcase. JC, I think he spotted me. Let me have a hot dog.
One hot dog.
Well, stop looking at him.
Think about it.
Yeah, well, you know.
We've got a problem.
Yeah, you got a problem using a consultant on a some sort of police sting operation. You got a lawsuit on your hands.
Jonathan?
We're quicker to run, the speed time takes him to change, but this is one of the scenes that we see in the credits at the beginning that we haven't seen yet, the horse jumping. Why didn't you do that before? You were close enough to punch him.
I think his little tick is our unit wound up with a collar. He's been trying to break that Columbia connection for the past year.
Again, our unit. I don't understand what they do.
It means that you could join Ty and I on our camping expedition.
Birch Hollow is exactly that. It is the sleepiest and the most peaceful place on Earth.
Yeah. Speak too soon. So we're probably going to see that shot of them being covered in mud as well then by the car. I think those are the ones we haven't seen yet.
You really should do something about that broken glass. A person could get hurt.
Oh, it's Freddy Krueger.
We want those petitions. You were stupid enough to pass them around. Let's get out of here.
Don't think they're very happy with him. He's printing petitions.
Ah! Look out!
Oh, I felt that. That's the really inappropriate car to be driving on that kind of road.
What we have here is a bent front axle.
Expensive as well.
The main road's just up ahead. What was that?
Sound like a bear?
Oh, just some predator tracking his kill.
Ha! As long as they're not the kill.
Aha! I think our luck may be about to change.
Ha
I think I was lucky. Would
yeah.
you?
Huh?
I don't do camping. I'm not a camping kind of person. Though we used to go caravanning when I was little. My parents had their own caravan. That is certainly, I think, next step up from camping. So it's a kind of, you know, indoors. You have the comfort of a bed, TV and stuff. Yeah, I am not a tent man. So that paper says something about mobsters. They certainly all look like a mob, don't they?
Hey, you look terrific.
How are you?
Fine. You can tell your fellows to take it easy. There won't be any trouble here.
I mean, they greeted each other. So I hugged each other, so I don't think they're enemies. I'm assuming they're all kind of maybe parts of a mob meeting up. And he's saying, basically, you can stand your men down. There's no problems going on here. It's not like they are a problem and they're fighting. That's how I kind of read it.
Hey, listen to me. There is a car coming.
I wouldn't let them in my car. The mess they're in.
Get in! Get in!
No, Charles, they were covered in mud.
Well, that's some storm. I knew it'd be a big one.
And again, that's a really inappropriate car for the road.
Please meet you.
Howdy.
Look at the road!
Folks would like a little something to make country living more bearable. There you are, try a sample of that.
Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do.
Have you any idea what these limousines might be doing out here?
Well, I'm not sure. Well, the old hotel's up ahead.
Didn't look like an old hotel, looked like a nice hotel. Because I kind of noticed it looks like this is meant to be like a sleepy little place, and they had like a nice looking hotel. It didn't seem to match the way JC described it. I didn't mention it earlier, so yeah, it's not an old hotel.
Whenever this valley was threatened with evil, and the Golden Bear would wipe it out.
So we saw in the flash, not flashback, flash forward kind of thing, at the preview at the beginning of the episode, there was a bear going through the window. So I wonder if that is JC as the bear, or are we meant to think that, and we actually find out it is this mysterious, legendary bear who turned up to do it. We'll see. So they booked out the whole hotel for their family get together.
The entire hotel has been booked by a private group.
You, sir, happen to be in the presence of New York's finest.
Finest what?
That's not the best thing to shout out in the middle when there's some mobsters all around you.
You ever seen a gold shield?
And it's also highly improper to be using your police credentials to favour a service like this. She didn't even say come in. He just knocked and opened the door and walked in. He might as well not bother knocking. What if she... I mean, she's only got a dressing gown on as it is. What if she didn't have anything on? Blimey.
And that crazy old man.
Colourful, not crazy.
Well, I guess it's perfectly normal to worship a big bad bear.
All folklore, all legend is normally based on some degree of truth.
That is true.
I'll finish getting ready.
He might as well change there, because he'll just walk in anyway.
Huh. Phytolacca americana.
So was that his normal sense of smell? Because it might be that that plant actually is fragrant. He might smell it. Or was that his enhanced senses again smelling it? We'll never know, I'm sure.
Get up. Now you tell me where my brother is right now.
So she thinks he's one of the mob? Not a good idea if you do think it's one of the mob to put a gun to their back. Yeah, not a good idea at all. Where's her brother? So the mob have taken her brother? Is he the guy who had that printing press shop?
Coming.
See, that's how you do it. You knock and you wait.
Where's JC?
I just watched him drive off with a very attractive woman.
With a shotgun in her hand.
Well, I think it's pretty inconsiderate.
Me too. Worst of it is he won't tell me how he does it.
That's quite a good line.
You people really think you have the world by the tail, don't you?
Not the best gun to have for close range capture like that, though. If it was sawn off, it'd be a little bit easier. But he could easily grab the barrel in an instant and turn it away. So, yeah, which I'm sure he probably will do in a minute. And it wouldn't have been easy to keep it on him in the car either. So cramped. There's not enough space to have a gun that long, a barrel, on him.
You don't want me to get in there. Oh, this is silly. I mean, I could suffocate.
Probably not. Not in a wooden case like that, just in a room like that.
Let me out of here.
So he's going to turn to an ant, so he can sort of crawl through a little gap. Okay, so they said that they rented out the hotel for a private function. Those people don't look like they're in the mob, but I did see it said the hotel had a restaurant. So it might be that the hotel, the rooms are booked out, but the restaurant is still open to the public. because that's what it looks like. It still doesn't look like an appropriate hotel or restaurant for the area.
You know who those guys are? The tall ones with the New York syndicate.
Why wouldn't they be in a private room somewhere?
I thought you said you were one of New York's finest.
But he's not. He's not a police officer. God, is that the water supply? It's not like... Is that pipe coming in from the top? I can't tell because it's so low resolution. I can't tell. Okay, so maybe there is some rainwater being captured outside and it comes down into that barrel and then they use it. Yeah, okay, there is.
Hope we didn't come at a bad time.
How do you know where the gun was?
It's got something to do with certain petitions that would tie the hand of your town council.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Okay, so that could sway the town council. So there's some kind of... The mob are trying to pass something through the town council as a vote, I think, or something. Don't know what yet. And they've been doing a petition with the locals to go against it. And they have lots of petitions and signatures, which would mean that the council would have to reject whatever it is. And they're trying to find the petitions to get rid of them. So there's basically no opposition to whatever they're trying to do.
Pay dirt. We got him right here.
Get rid of it.
Put the fire. Panther. Can a panther still get out of a locked box? Still trapped in the box. To be honest, it's quite a bit of height to it. He probably could have used his legs lying down to kick open the box. Panther can't.
What the hell is that?
How's he going to explain that to her? Oh, is it fire? Drag her out. Knock the water over. Depends how much water's in there. That would have put out that one at the end.
We had planned to wait until tomorrow to unveil the model. But as long as we're all here...
They're building something.
I give you the new Birch Hollow Resort and Casino.
Doesn't seem right for the area.
Ah, the voting is nothing but a formality, strictly ceremonial.
They're so incompetent.
I'm a police officer and this man works with me.
Cops?
I'm gonna have to take you both in.
On what charges?
Invasion of privacy. Damaging hotel property.
Get him out of here.
What happened?
You had a nasty fall.
I was gonna pass it off as concussion.
Relax, you obviously had a bad dream.
Well, they want to legalize gambling in Birch Hollow.
Backwards Atlantic City.
Exactly, only they need the unanimous consent of the whole city council. My brother Jack's on the town council. Jack, he began writing editorials about how the casino would destroy the way of life in Birch Hollow.
Okay, it was the printed place, it was a newspaper production place. That makes sense that they did look like that. They had a cheap printing press and they produced the papers locally like that. So it sounds like they're not a great story. They're trying to build a huge 20-floor casino in this tiny backwater place. Like I said, like a backwater Atlantic City. I assume they can build it on the cheap there. And if it's mob-owned, I suppose it's money laundering as well. They put money through it. So it's kind of better to build it in the backwater like that. It's probably not intended to be a proper fully... Well, it will be a casino, but they're not planning on the casino being the proper attraction. It's probably just putting money through the books, I assume.
They destroyed a petition that we'd spent weeks circulating that would have taken the authority out of the town council's hands to sell us down the river.
And when does the council vote?
2 days from now. And with Jack missing, there's nothing to stop them. They have all the rest of the votes sewn up.
So it has to be unanimous. So if only one of them says no, that's a bit silly. If only one has to say no to stop it. I completely agree it should always be like a majority thing. One person shouldn't have all the power either way, good or bad, really. Because who's to say what's good?
you help me find Jack?
I kidnapped you with a shotgun and locked you in the box. Please help me.
Why'd you have to say you're a cop? See, that's the trouble with you. Start spitting out the truth before you even given a lie.
You did it at the hotel.
Where's JC when you need him?
It's not him, but they think it is, or she does.
There. Jonathan, come here, Jonathan.
It's just a mouse.
He's trying to tell us something.
One sweep for yes, two sweeps for no, okay? You trying to tell us something, JC? You're right.
What? Hang on. One squeak for yes, two squeaks for no, and it goes squeak, 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 squeak. So what was that?
Is it a book or a movie?
Is he going to turn up? Yeah. Oh, so drop the mouse.
Where I come from, law enforcement agencies work together. That is, if they are actually enforcing the law.
They're going to lock him in as well.
Go along with him as soon as look at you.
Oh, Sheriff, I don't scare that easily.
They can't let him leave. Surely they'd stop him, because he can make a phone call.
These people know too much already.
Enhanced hearing.
A pretty young cop got murdered by that low-life hoodlum in the cell with her.
Yeah, when you tried to stop it, I was a witness.
But you got there too late, so you had to kill him. Wait till tonight, then move.
Is he? Oh, bear. Again, can a bear knock a wall down? Pretty easy targets.
Not just a bear. The golden bear was here.
Oh, well, again, like I said, I wonder if maybe it wasn't JC. Maybe it was this magical bear that saved the town. I suspect that's kind of the twist that we'll have in this story.
I think I hit one of them.
Oh, you think you hit one of them? Well, why the hell didn't you find out?
Yeah, why didn't they go after them? I mean, yeah, it looks like they did hit him, so he's limping. It's not like they could run away at full speed. They weren't that far behind them. Why didn't they chase after them?
Want a rest, Ty?
Yeah.
This is why I don't like camping. Things like this happen.
Very clever of you, rescuing us as that bear.
A bear.
Yep.
Well, the medical help we need is growing in these
flowers.
Woods. Or crawling.
Well, the sort of
did
creatures.
Say crawling?
Yeah, what creatures has a natural antiseptic? I think there's some plants that you can use to wrap wounds that do have a natural healing part to it, but I don't know what they are. I'm pretty sure that's the case.
Stop here. You just lost him. That's all. There's some prints over here. There's shoe prints. It's a man's print.
Yeah, cute dogs.
I don't get it.
So it was him as the bear, and he's just saying it wasn't?
I don't understand. How can all the phone lines be out?
That phone box looks like it's in literally the middle of nowhere. Why would there be a phone box there? That's crazy. Best bet to change direction. Don't keep running straight. Take a 90 degree turn and go off one way or the other.
Never know who you're going to run into in the middle of a cornfield.
They could kill her there easily with no witnesses. Nobody would find her for
ages.
I'll
give you a proxy signed by your brother. Since he couldn't be there to do the vote on Sunday, he wanted you to do the honors and make it unanimous.
They forced him to sign it, or faked it. Would you be allowed to have like a veto if someone else vote for you? And it sounds like she could vote either way. I mean, the people, I would assume, elected the people on the board. It's not quite having someone unelected doing the vote.
Dogs. They must have picked up our scent.
So he's going to change into something to take the dogs off in a different direction. They're trying to follow a stream by the looks of it. Water's the best bet. Get to a river or something.
That's it. Next time,
but there's no water.
Is Zeke in Sadie's car?
Most certainly is.
They'll follow you straight there.
Oh, we got company. Coming.
Got proper like moonshine still.
You know the sheriff's looking out for you folks.
We were hoping we could stay here until the dust clears.
Heck yeah, there ain't no love lost between us and the sheriff.
I don't understand this. The dogs will follow them straight there.
Zeke Bethune's place. And leave the dogs behind. We don't want to ruin the surprise.
I think I'll have a look outside.
Well, that's a stupid idea. It's a stupid idea for a healthy person to go out and do it. Especially when he's got bullet in his leg. He needs to be resting.
I think they're gonna kill us.
What gave it away?
Mess. All loaded, just in case.
So I think she had a shotgun, and he's got a rifle. They're too far away. That's completely ineffective at that range. If you could throw it and hit the car, maybe, but they're way too far away. Is she... the woman's there in the background writing stuff down. She's working out how much they owe. What they're using. Yeah,
this body's on me.
They wouldn't explode like that. They would just be flame appearing on the ground. They're not bombs or grenades. They're fire bombs. Might set the lawn on fire because it's quite dry there. That's what they need to hit.
There's no way we're gonna outrun them on foot.
What about that couple now, though? They're running away, but their house is all shot up. They've lost most of their stock of all of the stuff the alcohol that they make their livelihood out of. And basically, they've been harbouring fugitives. I mean, their lives are wrecked.
Be there from here! Be there from here!
Like they had time to do all that.
Where are you hiding Jack Slocum?
I'll hang here till I rot before I tell you where he is.
Oh, you just did. The sheriff had pollen on his clothing. Oconee bells.
We find the flowers. Chances are we can find the hideout.
Gotta find the flowers.
Follow me. Where are you going?
Sorry. Have to fly.
Okay, so he's going to turn into a hawk, fly above and look for the flowers. Like they'd be able to see him from the height he's at.
If it was up to me, I'd have gotten rid of that punk over there a long time ago.
From what I hear after the vote, you may just get your wish.
So they're going to save him and get in there just in time for the vote where he'll vote no. They're kind of doing it all with like this urgency to get it done for the vote. But surely, if after the fact... after the vote, basically, they found out that this was all happening, that people were held hostage to make, you know, to make the vote go their way. Surely they could all be reversed. Yeah, because it's obviously highly illegal, and that, if the sheriff was involved as well, so it's not like it's going to be completely legally binding if all of this is happening, surely.
Let's go! Nice and easy. Come on.
Oh, shit. She had a gun on her. How did she have a gun on her? She had a pistol. That would have been taken from her when she was in the jail. Then, from the jail, they were on the run and then got to that house, and they weren't given a pistol at the house. They were given a shotgun. So, where did that pistol come from? Oh, the sheriff's. They took... well, I didn't see them take it, but they must have taken the sheriff's gun. Maybe it was in the car. A bit weird.
Come on, Jack. We've still got time to make that meeting.
It's at the old hotel, which is really a huge conference center.
When I call your name, sign your name on the scroll to support the casino. Don't sign it if you're foolish enough to vote against it.
No pressure.
We're waiting.
Stop!
Just in time.
These people are kidnappers and murderers. I have the evidence to prove
it. Yeah. Not the best thing to do when they've all got guns, though. Yeah, it's not him. It's the Golden Bear.
Halt! You're under arrest for criminal conspiracy.
Yeah, why would you hit a bear with a chair? You don't do that. You run. Maybe it is him. He'd have turned into the bear to keep the story going.
Oh, Jonathan.
Professor, was there a bear?
Answer him.
What? Spoil the fun.
Wasn't a great way to end the episode, yet alone the series. Wasn't an awful episode. Again, they always have like a... Back then, these sort of shows always had like a mob episode. Like we had the Chinatown episode. The story was... the plot of the story was a bit weak. It didn't kind of make sense, them building the casino there and stuff. That seems a bit weird. But it was an alright one. Again, not the best one to end the story on, and obviously it didn't end the series. Now, if I remember rightly, there was a show a few years later called, I think it was called Nightman. That was another short-lived show, but they actually had an episode called Manimal, I think, and he actually made an appearance in that show as Manimal. Unfortunately, I haven't been able to get the DVD, so I can't show that. But, yeah, that's out there, I think. It was a funny show. I don't mean funny, ha-ha. Well, some of it was, but probably wasn't meant to be. I can understand why it was cancelled after so few episodes. But it is definitely one I wanted to watch and react to, just because I do remember it when I was... I remember watching it, but I never remembered the detail. I just knew I'd seen some of them. I mean, none of them were familiar to me at all. But it's just this kind of show with like Street Hawk, Airwolf. I remember when I was little, they just gave me helped expand my imagination, basically. So that's why I was kind of enjoyed these kind of shows when I was little. Although I still think this one terrified me, I'm sure. So yeah, let me know what you thought about this one in the comments below. Can't announce what the next show is going to be just yet, but have a look at the banner on the top of my page, and it'll have the next show either now or in the next couple of days. Yeah, and I shall see you for the next episode. Be seeing you.